in 2 Corinthians, the 9th chapter, the 15th verse. Just listen to it. Thanks be to God for his unspeakable gift. Thanks be to God for his unspeakable gift. I would imagine that at home, you have a Christmas tree all decorated. Do you? And are there some presents under the tree? There are. Yeah. And I suppose on Christmas Eve, or maybe on Christmas Day, you're going to open those presents. Are you? I don't know how you do it, but I know some families, each one gets a chance to go to the tree and pick out a present. And usually we know which presents belong to us, don't we? We've been peeking many times, haven't we? And so we pick it up and we say, this one's mine. And your mother or your father will probably say, who's it from? And you'll look at it and you'll say, well, that's from grandmother or grandfather or Uncle John or whoever it may be. And you think of the person who gave that present to you. Why did they give it to you? Because they love you. Because they love you. Well, at Christmas time, God gave us a gift too. Why did he give that? Because he loves us, doesn't he? God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. God gave that gift. And if there were a little tag on it, you know, you'd look at it and you'd say, this is a gift from God. And it is, isn't it? It's a gift from God. And then you look again, who is it for? Each one of us. God gave his gift for each one of us, didn't he? Are you sure he gave it to you? Well, let me tell you a little bit of a story I read. In New York City, that's a big city. I've never been there. Yeah, I've been there, but not really either. Okay, New York City. On Christmas Eve, a very poor man, very hungry and cold, walked past the big church, and some of the lights were on, so he tried the door. It was open. He went in. He wanted to get warm. It was cold outside. He walked inside, and in the church was a man working with some food baskets. Apples and oranges and some ham and a lot of good things to eat in those baskets. And there were so many of them. And the man said, can I buy one of those baskets? What do they cost? The poor man asked. And the man said, no, these aren't for sale. You can't buy them. How can I get one? He asked. How can I get one? Well, he said, you have to qualify. You know what that means? You have to qualify. Well, it kind of means you have to be worthy of it, huh? Worthy of it. Well, the poor man thought a little bit and he said, well, I guess I can't have any. I can't qualify. Well, the man in the church asked, are you hungry? And he said, yeah, I haven't had anything to eat for a couple days. I'm hungry. Then he said, you qualify. You qualify. Pick out any basket you want. And he said, I don't have the money. No. He said, you can't buy this basket. You can only have it free for nothing. You just have to be hungry. Well, he said, then I qualify. Then I can have one of the baskets. How do you receive God's gift? Can you buy that gift? You can't buy it, can you? Can you work for it and earn it? No, you can't. You have to qualify. And do you know how you qualify? God gave his gift to each one of us because you and I need a Savior to save us from sin, to open the gates of heaven for us. We've all done bad things, haven't we? And God loved us so much that he gave us the Savior Jesus so that our sins could be taken away. We qualify. We qualify if you're hungry for God's love, and if you're hungry for it, and we are, aren't we? Yes, we are. So he says here, this gift is for you, and you and I look at it carefully, and we praise and thank God for that gift, don't we? then too. But God's gift was wrapped so beautifully too. He wrapped it in swaddling clothes and it was laid in a manger. And you're going to tell the story this evening, aren't you? On that first Christmas, God sent angels from heaven. Oh, how happy they must have been, and your angels, to tell the story. Well, this evening, he's not going to have, you know, that kind of angel, those kind of angels he'll have. But he uses you, each one of you, as his angel, as his messenger to tell the story. And I know you're going to be just as excited as the first angels were. Remember the passage, thanks be to God for his unspeakable gift. It's so wonderful that there aren't words sufficient to tell us about that gift. May Jesus bless you with much happiness as you tell that story this evening. God be with you and fill your hearts with much joy and excitement.
Whatever you Maybe we're on the wrong hillside.
In the same country, shepherds.
If there were a big thing, shepherds would not be able to do it. And the angel said unto him, "Fear not. when Jesus is born in Bethlehem of Judea, and they say that the king, behold, there came wise men from the east, saying, "Where is he that is born king of the Jews? For we have seen the star in the east, and have come to worship him."
Rose our arms to the east, and before the king stood over where he
have many ways of thanking God for his gift, don't we? And one of them this evening is to bring our offering of love to worship the Lord. And it's just a small way of saying thank you, God, for that very precious gift of a Savior at Christmas time. Thank you that you came at Christmas time to be our Savior and our Lord. We open our hearts to receive you, and as you come into our hearts and our lives and our homes, fulfill the promise that you have given, that you will bring hope and love and joy and peace, so that we can put these Christian virtues to practice in our individual lives, in our homes, and our communities. For then truly it will be Christmas in our hearts and in our homes and where we live our lives. Hear us, Lord Jesus, as you so graciously promised. For we join our hearts and our voices in that prayer you taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Go out into the world with that blessed Christmas peace in your hearts and your lives. Have courage, hold to what is good, return no man evil for evil, strengthen the faint-hearted, support the weak, help the suffering, honor all men. And the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and grant you his peace.